Exploring autoimmune diseases, creative brainstorming. What do allergies, chronic inflammations, cancer, and autoimmune diseases have in common? These are four groups of diseases that reflect long-term immune failure. The number of four groups is, of course, not accidental. It has a logical explanation given later. If we understand the underlying causes of immunodeficiency in depth, maybe we can also understand how to cure autoimmune diseases. The idea that autoimmune diseases cannot be cured is fundamentally wrong. Remissions reinforce the idea that autoimmune diseases are curable. In the following slides, I will briefly describe the logical aspects of this theory with some new concepts and ideas. What do these four groups of diseases have in common? Allergies, chronic inflammations, cancer, autoimmune diseases. Conclusion: each group of diseases represents a different type of immune system long-term malfunctioning. Introduction. Disclaimer: this theoretical discussion should not be regarded as a recommendation for any action or treatment. Medical science makes extensive use of advanced technology. But surprisingly and paradoxically, medicine has no unified philosophy, contrary to expectations. In this video, we will conduct a deep brainstorming session that will illustrate the dilemmas and solutions offered by medicine versus the internal logic of each of us, including various philosophical and innovative conceptions. This video with few alterations is based on the principles presented in Dr. Nader Bhutto's books, Medicine and the Seventh Sense, Medicine and the Seven Laws, while introducing new ideas. Is there a unified philosophy of modern medical science today? The answer is, no. Is there a need for a unified philosophy of medical science? The answer is definitely yes. The medical field in the 21st century is a war zone, dictated by modern lifestyle. Would anyone allow himself entering a fierce war without a strategy? I guess not. Philosophy of medicine should draw boundaries, point out possible causes and the optimal way of treatment, as well as methods to avoid causes versus symptoms. The first question every autoimmune disease patient should ask himself or herself is whether autoimmune diseases is a symptom or the cause. It is quite understandable that autoimmune disease is a symptom, but the underlying causes remain unclear. It is somewhat known that genetics have a role, but it cannot explain most autoimmune diseases. Researchers now focus on the new field of epigenetics, the environmental expression on the human genes. What is the logic of treating symptoms if the causes are unclear? Opportunities. The treatment of autoimmune diseases is designed to prevent pain and severe side effects. It is not able, and does not pretend, to bring about the patient's recovery. Disadvantages. Treating symptoms is like extinguishing fire without removing the combustion material that caused the ignition in the first place. The problem is that a new fire could burst at any moment. Prolonged drug therapy severely damages the immune system, which is already compromised. The treatment itself may further degrade the patient. Without any real hope for recovery, the patient may be depressed, draws energy from the body. Why scientists still did not achieve a significant breakthrough in the field of autoimmune diseases. Modern lifestyle is unhealthy in the first place. Anxiety and stress, combined with poor nutrition and environmental pollutions, are conditions that no drug or invasive treatment can cure. So the conclusion is that there is nothing to do? Certainly not. There's a lot to do. What is the life force energy? Qi in Chinese culture. The life force energy is all around us, and in every organ of our body. Without the life force energy, we will die. Interference of life force energy flow can result in physical imbalance and illness. The concept of life force energy is widespread in the Far East. Chinese acupuncture and martial arts are based on controlling this energy, but in Western culture, it is difficult to accept this abstract concept. What are the two leading medical approaches today for autoimmune treatments? Conventional modern medicine. The treatment is primarily based on steroids, suppressing the immune system, plasma transfusions, receptor blockers, and drugs tailored to the various diseases. Self-healing medicine, perceived as alternative medicine. Advocating the elimination of mental traumas that result in a decrease in life force energy. Particularly healthy lifestyle. Both mental and physical. Varied unprocessed nutrition and sustained detoxification. The Four Life Phases Model. By Dr. Nader Bhutto. All the energetic processes in nature, from the single cell to the entire universe, are characterized by the dynamic energy flow, consists of four phases. Stimulation. Expansion. Contraction. Relaxation. Prominent examples. Mitosis, cell division, consists of four phases. Prophase, metaphase, anaphase, telophase. Body organs, respiratory system and heartbeat. Each has four phases. Seasons, spring, summer, fall, winter. Life cycle, birth, maturity, old age, death. Applies also for stars. All matter has four phases, gas, liquid, plasma, solid. Matter and energy have dual properties. What makes autoimmune diseases different from the other three groups? Allergies, chronic inflammations, cancer, autoimmune diseases. Autoimmune diseases reflect blockage in the relaxation phase. Fourth in the life phases model, the body's energy in general and the specific organ is the second lowest among the four. After cancer, it is illustrated and explained in the next slides. The integrated model of long-term immunodeficiency diseases. Interference with the energetic flow of the relaxation phase, blue color, is the primary cause of all autoimmune diseases. Since the integrated model is not intuitive, a small familiar analogy. Let's think for a moment about the human body as if it were a car whose gearbox had a malfunction while driving. Transmission is not possible. Let's examine the primary scenarios. Stimulation. If we are traveling at too low a speed, the travel time is very long, and we are late for everything we have planned. Expansion. If we travel too fast to the road conditions, the trip will be bouncy and very uncomfortable. Contraction. If we want to stop, we must push the brakes with great force, especially if the car gets stuck in high gear. Relaxation. If we want to turn around or go back, we can't. The Four Life Phase Integrated Model regarding autoimmune diseases. Blocking or interfering with the flow of life force energy during the relaxation phase, fourth phase, marked in blue, is the leading cause of autoimmune diseases. The location is never accidental. Autoimmune disease hits the weakest spot on the energetic level. Autoimmune diseases are characterized by deficient life force energy that is due in part to traumatic events from the past. Most of them subconscious. Symptomatic treatments, such as medications, usually cannot cure the patient, as they do not eliminate the causes of the disease. Autoimmune diseases, all types, underlying causes are always a dynamic combination of these two primary elements, body, mind and spirit. Lifestyle versus genetics. An unhealthy lifestyle, mental and physical, is the leading cause of all types of autoimmune diseases. 80% or more. Genetics explains only a small part of the failures. 20% or less. Physical body. Unhealthy lifestyle reflected in improper nutrition, high body toxicity, low physical activities, and exposure to the sun. Lack of sleep, causes. Poor flow of body fluids. Blood, lymph, bile. Gut flora imbalance and parasite overgrowth, which causes a heavy load on the immune system. Mind and spirit. Anxiety, stress and traumatic non-resolved mental and spiritual events from our past can block the body's chi energy life force. Why are self-healing, alternative, autoimmune diseases treatments challenging right now? The social pressure that raises profound questions makes it difficult for the patient to go against the flow. Turning to alternative medicine, self-healing, usually occurs after the failure of conventional medicine. Although there are specialized self-healing clinics, a good deal of care is placed on the patient himself and his environment. Are you confused by now? The choice is one of two complicated options. conventional modern medicine that treats mainly the symptoms with no real hope for recovery, disregarding the energetic properties we all possess. Self-healing medicine, contrary to mainstream, and raises questions and social pressure. Besides, most of the therapeutic and mental burden is on the patient and his or her environment. The decision which type of medicine to choose is often a default decision. A more profound decision requires brainstorming, disturbing questions. Which of the two methods is preferable? The answer depends on the patient's confidence in the method, the attending physician, and, of course, his worldview. Can the two approaches be combined? The methods can be combined, although it is doubtful that you will receive such recommendations from conventional doctors. It is worth noting that aggressive treatments contradict self-healing. Summary. Autoimmune diseases are characterized by deficient life force energy that is due in part to traumatic events from the past, most of them subconscious. What allergies, chronic inflammations, cancer, autoimmune diseases have in common? These are four groups of diseases that reflect long-term immune failure. The idea that autoimmune diseases cannot be cured is fundamentally wrong. The theme of self-healing medicine involves many philosophical and practical issues. The full article is available on the sfhealing.com website.